everyone. Welcome to the physics class. This is Saurabh Sardana. So welcome to the physics class very first time, because you are going to admitted in class 11th while taking the stream non-medical or medical. So we are going to study physics today. This is the introduction class, so we are doing introduction of the physics only. So first of all, we should know about our subject. It means what we are going to study today. I'm sure after completing this lesson, today's lecture, you will be clear about that what is physics and what are the branches of the physics and what is the scope and excitement of physics. So let us move to the lecture. So first question is, what is physics? Look at here, what is it written? What is physics? Physics is the branch of science. Physics is the branch of science. Science, already you have studied about the physics, chemistry and biology in the class 10th, 9th. So we are now moving some microscopic phenomena of the physics. So physics is the branch of science, as we all know, but which deals with nature and natural phenomena. Physics is that branch of physics, science, which deals with the nature and natural phenomena. That is called physics. It is the branch of science. Okay. So what is nature? What we see all around us is nature. It means what is happening around us in our nature. Okay. It means if the seasons are changing, that is our natural process, natural phenomena. So sun rises, sunset, morning, evening sessions. So these are all the nature and natural phenomena. So physics is all about to explain these type of phenomena. What is all about nature and natural phenomena? What is happening around us? Why the lightning is in the sky? Okay, why the volcano occurs? These all studies based under the subject of physics. So there are many different phenomena occur in nature. So physics also divided into different parts, different groups. It is divided for the study of the different phenomena occurring in nature. So first, its branch physics also has some branches. Okay, if we want to study, physics is of two types. First of all, first is classical physics, and second one is modern physics. First one is classical physics and second one is modern physics. Okay, so first is classical physics. Is what is it? Up to year 1900, okay, means aaj 2020 year chal raha na, to up to year 1900 tak ki jo bhi physics discover hui, that is called classical physics. It means the physics discovered up to the year 1900, that is called classical physics. What was in it? It was based on only macroscopic phenomena. Macroscopic phenomena ke upar ya bodies ke upar ye discuss karti thi. What is the meaning of macro? Macro means large. Nature mein jo bhi large size ke object hote the, उन्हीं के ऊपर ही ये फिजिक्स सारी के सारी डील करती थी. जो माइक्रोस्कोपिक थे, इट मींस कोई एटम हो गया, एटम का स्ट्रक्चर हो गया, मींस माइक्रोस्कोपिक वायरस, इन्हीं के ऊपर जो स्टडी करना, तो माइक्रोस्कोपिक में आता है. तो माइक्रोस्कोपिक में उस टाइम की स्टडी नहीं थी, बट एट दैट टाइम द स्टडी वॉज ऑल अबाउट द मैक्रोस्कोपिक थिंग्स, जो बड़े साइज के ऑब्जेक्ट्स हमारे आसपास थे उन्हीं के ऊपर स्टडी होती थी, जैसे सन हो गया. ओके तो आसपास के जो बड़े फिनोमिनाज थे, बड़े ऑब्जेक्ट्स थे, उन्हीं के ऊपर स्टडी करती थी. दैट वॉज क्लासिकल फिजिक्स अप टू 1900 डिस्कवर्ड दैट मैक्रोस्कोपिक ऑब्जेक्ट, मैक्रोस्कोपिक फिनोमिनाज के ऊपर ये स्टडी थी सारी की सारी. वट वॉज सेकेंड पार्ट नाउ मॉडर्न फिजिक्स आफ्टर ईयर 1900 ईयर के बाद की जो फिजिक्स डिस्कवर्ड हुई है दैट इज ऑल अबाउट कॉल्ड मॉडर्न फिजिक्स एंड दिस डील्स ऑल अबाउट द माइक्रोस्कोपिक बॉडीज. माइक्रोस्कोपिक मीन्स वेरी स्मॉल साइज विच कैन नॉट बी सीन विद आवर नेक्ड आई, जिनको हम अपनी नंगी आंखों से नहीं देख सकते, उन बॉडीज को जो समझाती है दैट इज मॉडर्न फिजिक्स. आफ्टर 1900 की जो फिजिक्स था उसको माइक्रो के ऊपर फोकस किया गया था कि जो माइक्रो थिंग्स एटम है, एटम का स्ट्रक्चर है, तो ये सारी चीज़ें माइक्रो लेवल की हैं, तो माइक्रो लेवल की चीज़ों को समझाने के लिए मॉडर्न फिजिक्स है. सो देर इज टू टाइप ऑफ फिजिक्स, दैट इज क्लासिकल फिजिक्स एंड सेकेंड वन इज मॉडर्न फिजिक्स. दीज ऑल फिजिक्स, टू टाइप ऑफ फिजिक्स ऑल्सो हैज सम ऑफ द ब्रांचेज फॉरवर्ड, सो वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द ब्रांचेज ऑफ द फिजिक्स नाउ. So, branches of the physics are, there are five branches to be studied. First one is mechanics. First one is called mechanics. Mechanics deal with the motion of the body at low speed. It means some of the objects around us are moving at very high speed and some of the objects are moving at very low speed. So, the objects which are moving at very low speed, they are to be covered under the study of mechanics. Under the study of mechanics. Okay, it means if any object around us moving at very low speed, so we are going to study the motion of that slow moving object. It means we are doing their study under the branch of physics that is called mechanics. Mechanics is also further branches of it, that is dynamics, statics and kinematics, which we'll study later in the earlier in the coming sessions. Okay, second is electromagnetism. This branch of the physics deals with the electricity and magnetism and their relation also. Electricity ka concept hai. In the class 10th physics, the first chapter was electricity. Okay, and second was all about magnetism. So electricity and magnetism we are studying, so that is under the branch of electromagnetism. So we are studying electromagnetism and what is the relation between them, how can we produce magnetism using electricity or electricity can be produced using the magnetism, that is the concept of electromagnetism. Third one is thermodynamics. It means transfer of heat. अगर हम एक चाय का कप रख देते हैं बाहर तो थोड़ी देर के बाद ठंडा हो जाता है, इट मीन्स हीट हैज़ बीन ट्रांसफर्ड फ्रॉम दैट कप ऑफ टी टू दी सराउंडिंग. हाउ दैट हीट ट्रांसफर्स, वाई दैट ट्रांसफर्स फ्रॉम द कप ऑफ टी टू द सराउंडिंग, नॉट सराउंडिंग टू द टी, चाय और गर्म क्यों नहीं हुई. इट मीन्स दैट ऑलवेज ट्रांसफर ऑफ हीट स्टडीड अंडर द ब्रांच ऑफ फिजिक्स दैट इज कॉल्ड थर्मोडायनामिक्स. दैट इज कॉल्ड thermodynamics is the study of transfer of heat. Next one is modern physics, already we have studied. Microscopic bodies, small size ki bodies ke upar kisi bhi internal body ka structure karna ho microscopic level. Next is optics. Optics is nature of light and its propagation. It means light, sun ki light hai, nature light. To uska nature kaisa hai, पार्टिकल नेचर है, वेव नेचर है, एंड हाउ इट प्रोपोगेट, चलती कैसे है लाइट, हाउ द लाइट ट्रेवल्स. दिस ऑल लाइट प्रॉपर्टीज आर स्टडीड अंडर द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ ऑप्टिक्स. इन द क्लास 10th यू हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड अबाउट द चैप्टर रिफ्लेक्शन एंड रिफ्रैक्शन ऑफ लाइट एंड ऑल्सो द ह्यूमन आई चैप्टर. दैट वॉज ऑल अबाउट द पार्ट ऑफ ऑप्टिक बिकॉज देयर वॉज ओनली द कॉन्सेप्ट यूज वॉज लाइट बेस्ड ऑन रिफ्लेक्शन एंड रिफ्रैक्शन. So that was the branch of physics that is called optics. So there are five branches to be studied of the physics. I am explaining again mechanics, theory of the motion of the body at low speed. Okay, second is electromagnetism. What is electricity? What is magnetism? And what is the relation between them? Thermodynamics, how heat can be transferred from one body to the another body. And next one is modern physics, all about the study of the microscopic bodies, small size bodies. And next one is optics, nature of light, how light behaves and how light travels from the source of light to the receiver. These are the branches of physics we are going to study in 11th as well as in 12th. Optics will be studied in the 12th class. And the other jo hamare paas ye hain branches, we are going to study in class 11th. So now we are going to study the scope of physics. It means, what is the advantage of studying physics for us in future? That is called scope and excitement of physics. So why we study so wide physics? First advantage is this, length. Okay, there are different objects around us having different dimensions. Microscopic are there, macroscopic bahut zyada length ke bhi hote hain, bahut kam length ke bhi hote hain. Physics deals with the maximum length to the minimum length object. It means there is 10 to 26 meter is the size of our universe. 10 to 26 meter is the size of our universe. It means humne sabse bada size hamare universe ka hai, to universe ko bhi samjha sakti hai. And sabse chota size ek nucleus ka hota, that is 10 to power minus 15 meter. Size of the nucleus. To ek nucleus ke size ko bhi samjhaya hai isne. It means from the maximum to the minimum size existing in our nature, that can be studied by only the physics. Means physics can deal with the different dimensions, different length objects from 10 to 26 to 10 to power minus 15 meter. Okay, this is the scope and excitement of physics. This is the advantage of studying physics. It means different dimensions ke object ko hum study kar sakte hain, from 10 to 26 meter to 10 to power minus 15 meter, from maximum till date to the minimum till date. Next, time. Life of sun is 10 to 18 seconds, so we can study about the sun. Okay, that is having the maximum time on our universe, and minimum time is to whenever a particle or light travels through the nucleus, to cross the nucleus, light takes time 10 to power minus 22 seconds, as the nucleus is the smallest particle. Okay, as we have studied in the first point. So this is the minimum time. So physics can also study with the from maximum time to the minimum time. It means time ki limit bahut zyada hai, from maximum time to the minimum time in the nature. जिस भी प्रोसेस में लग रहा है, जितनी भी रेंजेस बीच में कवर होती हैं, सभी तरह के टाइम के प्रोसेसेस को स्टडी हम कर सकते हैं यूजिंग फिजिक्स. एंड व्हाट इज दिस मास, फ्रॉम हैवियर टू द लाइटर. एवरेज मास ऑफ आवर यूनिवर्स इज 10 टू 55 केजी, दैट इज ऑलरेडी बीन कैलकुलेटेड यूजिंग द फिजिक्स. एंड मास ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन इज द स्मॉलेस्ट पार्टिकल, दैट इज माइनस 30, एट अबाउट माइनस 30 केजी. इट मीन्स डिफरेंट मासेस, इन दोनों की रेंज में जितने भी मासेस पार्टिकल आते हैं उनको भी स्टडी हम कर सकते हैं. इट मीन्स फिजिक्स इज ऑल अबाउट टू स्टडी दी फ्रॉम द मैक्सिमम लेवल टू द मिनिमम लेवल ऑफ द लेंथ, टाइम एंड मास ऑफ द पार्टिकल एग्जिस्टिंग इन आवर यूनिवर्स टिल डेट. और आने वाले टाइम में भी, कभी फ्यूचर में, इससे भी लाइटर पार्टिकल या इससे भी हैवियर कोई चीज़ अगर कैलकुलेट हुई, तो दैट कैन ऑल्सो बी स्टडीड विद द एडवांटेज ऑफ फिजिक्स. दिस इज द स्कोप एंड एक्साइटमेंट ऑफ फिजिक्स. Why we study physics, this is the reason why we are going to so wider physics in our class 11th. Another advantage of the physics is that physics is related to the other branches of science also, as physics is related to chemistry. How? Physics develops X-rays, gamma rays, other type of different electromagnetic radiations are developed by the physics. Okay, and that X-rays are using in diffraction pattern of any light, or if you want to study the atomic structure in chemistry, that is only possible due to the X rays. Okay, it means physics relation to the chemistry also. Physics relation to the biology, life sciences. How? Because as you all know, in the biology, in the life sciences, we are going to study the internal structure of a body. That is only due to possible of the electromagnetic radiations developed by the physics or the microscope. We are going to study, and that is only based on the phenomena of the physics. Physics is also related to the mathematics also. Physics is related to the every branch of the mathematics, as various theories developed by the physics and studied under the concept of mathematics. Okay, means physics ke dwara kai aisi banayi gayi theories hain jo mathematics mein aap unko padhte ho. It means physics has a wider advantages in relation to the other branches of science, that is chemistry, life sciences, biology, and also to the mathematics. Astrophysics we are going to study. Astrophysics, what is it? We are going to launch a satellite. Okay, that is only based on physics concept. What is orbital speed? What is escape speed? We are going to study in unit 6 of the class plus 1. So physics has a wider advantages. As you all know, corona is going to be spreaded in our country day by day. So every scientist is now doing practice to find the vaccines to stop the spreading of the corona from one person to the another. That concept all based on the physics to find the vaccines. Okay, they are using the instrument, they are using the tools that is only developed with the help of the physics. It means physics has a wider advantage. It has a lot of scope and excitement. Physics has given us a lot of laws of nature also. We are going to study in the next lecture on tomorrow. So I think this was all about the 2 days lecture. Hope you all understood the 2 days concept. This was a demo class. So if you have any doubt, please WhatsApp on my personal WhatsApp wall. Contact number is given in the WhatsApp group. Okay, thanks and have a nice day.